This is Tiffany, the girl that just moved into your apartment, and this is Diana. She's a construction worker. And if you're wondering what they're doing here in this episode, I'm going to try to warp your perception on hard hats, what they do, why they're so important, and why you should always wear one when you need one. I'm going to be running these girls through a few different scenarios that you would encounter on, let's say, an unsafe construction site, to say the least. And here's the hard hats I'm going to be using. This is a $3 hard hat. This is a $6 hard hat, and this is a $12 hard hat. And just out of curiosity, they seem to be just slightly different, like the material. I'm gonna just take a regular old hammer and just give each one a whack so we can see if there's any difference in the flex of the material. That one, whoa, it fell. As we can see, all of those hard hats are about the same. So the hard hats I'm going to use for these tests are the $3 hard hat, the $12 hard hat, and one more hard hat that's my absolute favorite, the see-through transparent hard hat. This is cool. If you haven't seen this before, it's fully transparent. You can see right into the hard hat, see the whole suspension system at work. And yeah, these are the hard hats I'm going to use. Now here's the situation. Tiffany has wandered into a construction site looking for directions, and this is a dangerous situation because there are bricklayers working overhead that are very irresponsible, and they're about to drop a whole bunch of bricks down below from about 20 or 30 feet up. And since construction workers are such nice guys, as soon as Tiffany got into that construction site, they gave her this hard hat right here. And this is gonna be kind of interesting because, as you can see, she's striking a little bit of a pose, like a strut. I guess this makes sense because when you're walking through a construction site, if something's dropped from, you know, from overhead, you're not really standing like this waiting for it, right? You're probably walking or talking or just doing your thing, just like she is. Looking good. All right, let's do this drop, see what happens. It's gonna be interesting. Did you see that? She took that like a boss. She's even right here striking her pose like, what? Four bricks? That was nothing. I'm just gonna do one more drop with her with the bricks, but this time I'm going to use the see-through hard hat so we can see how the suspension system of the hard hat is working. And yeah, should be fun. All right, we're all set. Here goes the three bricks right on Tiffany's head with the see-through hard hat. It broke her neck. Oh no, that's terrible. That was a pretty hard hit. And that just goes to show you that just because you're wearing a hard hat, that doesn't mean you're not gonna get injured. I'm assuming she would still be alive, but this right here is definitely a trip to the hospital. I'm calling this a broken neck. And I'm pretty sure that this is because of the shape. She's kind of striking a pose like this. She kind of has her neck forward. But like I said, this is a realistic situation because if you get hit in the head with bricks, you're probably not gonna be in the ideal position to get hit. You're gonna be walking along doing your thing. So on to the next experiment. Tiffany's in the ambulance. She's on her way to the hospital. Now we're on to Diana. She is a legitimate construction worker, but she got the job because she knew somebody. So she really doesn't follow rules well, and she doesn't have that much experience, but she does have a hard hat, and she strolled into an area of the construction zone that's basically the no-go zone. There's a building that's falling apart, and there's some big old 2x4. They're actually 2x4 timbers that are gonna fall on her, and I hope she's gonna be okay, but in the name of science, God bless you. Let's get it done. All right, got all the boards up there on the lift, and I think I had a change of heart. Originally, I wanted to keep the yellow hard hat on her, but I think I'm just gonna go straight into the see-through hard hat, because as we saw with the other mannequin, Tiffany, her neck broke, so who knows what's gonna happen on the first drop. I put that do-rag in there for her to, I don't know, maybe she's hot, she's sweaty, but it's also keeping her hard hat a little tighter. These are genuine, legit, 2 inches by 4 inches by, I think those are 10 or 12 feet long, so it's quite a bit of weight. And again, this doesn't mean that she's gonna walk away unharmed. It's kind of like in a motorcycle accident. If you're wearing a helmet, your body's damaged, but your brain's still intact. Yeah, something like that. But let's see what happens this time. And yeah, this is gonna be the timbers. Good luck. All right, here goes one timber. Watch out, Diana. Oh no. Oh, Diana got hit. I don't know. We're gonna find out right now. Oh no. That's okay, we can put it back on. You are something else. Okay, so that was pretty cool. It didn't drop directly on her head, but I did realize another function of the hard hat here, and that is it kind of deflected the board and pushed it back away from her. Pretty interesting. I never really thought about that aspect of hard hat safety. So I'm gonna try to drop it one more time directly on her head, but this was definitely a good example of another safety feature of a hard hat. All right, let's get this reset. Get Diana back on the job. No workers comp for you. Maddie, can I have the arm, please? Okay, there we go, her arm's on. All right, she's ready to go. Let's get her hard hat. Throw me her hard hat, please. Throw it. Yeah, all right, let's do it. Oh no, watch out, Diana. Whoa, that was interesting for sure. Did you see that? The wood broke over her head. All right, that worked out pretty well. That was an almost perfect drop, dead center, right on the hard hat, to the point that it broke the wood right in half. I mean, this is a legit 2x4, some pretty strong wood. And that was a great example as to what the hard hat does. That was a perfect example, actually, because you could even see how the hard hat converted that high frequency, high impact force into a lower frequency shock, and you know, her neck absorbed some of the impact. We can see exactly how the hard hat protected her, and this is a great example. I just have one more test I want to do where I take the pneumatic hammer and show how the suspension system of the hard hat works. Let's do it. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is an occupational hazard or not, but here you go. Oh, hold on. In the high speed footage with that hammer, you can clearly see how the hard hat is absorbing the shock, especially how the suspension system works. That was kind of interesting. So that's about it for my set of experiments here with Diana and Tiffany. She's back there recovering. Check out the other videos on this channel. There's a whole bunch of other stuff that I do here, not just these type of videos, but all sorts of stuff. Don't forget to subscribe, drop a like, share your thoughts, leave a comment below, and I will see you next time. Children are pretty uninhibited and transparent about what they have to say. And the four-year-old helper today has said that mannequins don't feel pain, so this isn't really a fair test. So she wants to hit me in the head with a stick like this or something bigger. Hit it, hit me, hit me, hit me. Oh, that actually makes my ears ring a little bit. Yeah, that didn't really hurt, but you wanna hit me with a bigger stick?
Yeah.
Here goes our four-year-old assistant hitting me in the head with the stick, with a big stick. Okay, you have to step over here though. You gotta hit me a little harder, right here, right there. Okay, go ahead, hit me hard. Yeah, you got it? Right in the head. Go. Okay. That wasn't too bad. She was still hitting me as I was getting up, but yeah, the hard hat definitely works. I didn't really feel much of anything. I know she didn't hit me that hard, but that was kind of fun.